Hello everyone, as we already discussed about the centroid, today we are discussing about the orthocenter. The most important thing is that why orthocenter is being used and what is the actual meaning of the term orthocenter. Suppose we have a triangle ABC, or we can say these are basically three places. Let's say this is Delhi, this place is Jaipur, and this is Agra. These are the basically three highways connecting the three cities, and the government want that in between the three highways they should connect three cities together. Like this highway is connected to this highway, same way this BC highway is connected to highway A, B, and this highway is connected to this highway, and the government wants to make the highway in such a manner that it is the lowest closest distance between the points. Now, if in case we want to talk about a point having the shortest distance from this point, so we are very clear this line, so we are very clear that this is a line which is perpendicular to this line. So if in case from point B we make a perpendicular to a line AC, this is a perpendicular distance and this point is passing through E. So we can say from a point B, the lowest distance to the line AC is BE. Same way if in case from a point C, we want to see the lowest distance to a line AB is a perpendicular distance from C to AB. This is also perpendicular. Same way if in case I am going through A to F, and this is also perpendicular. So I can say that AF is the shortest distance from point A to the line BC. Same way, B is the shortest distance from point B to a line AC. Same way, CD is the shortest distance from line C to a from point C to a line AD. So we can say that D point, E point and F point, this triangle, the perimeter of the triangle DEF, that is the length of D plus the length of EF plus the length of DF, is the shortest possible distance between the line, so that the government is expending the least expenditure in making a road from D to E, E to F and F to D. So this is the shortest possible distance possible, and this point where they are connecting is known as the orthocenter. If in case we talk about orthocenter, it is very important that this orthocenter can be inside the triangle and this can also be outside the triangle. In the acute angle triangle, this is always inside the triangle, but when we talk about a right angle triangle, like a triangle ABC again, which is right angle at a point P, so this is a perpendicular line on BC and this is a perpendicular line on AB, and from here if we want a perpendicular and this is passing through D, so we can say that these all three are the perpendicular line, and this point is known as the orthocenter. So in our right angle triangle, the orthocenter is always a vertex. Why? If we talk about a triangle which is obtuse angled triangle. Now, if from point A I want a perpendicular line on BC, so it is something like this. From point C, if I want a perpendicular line on AB, this is like this, and if in case we want a perpendicular line on this, so this will pass through, all these will pass through a specific point, and this point is known as the orthocenter of the triangle ABC. Here there is one very important thing, that if O is the orthocenter of ABC, then B is the orthocenter of OAC, same way C is the orthocenter of OAB, and A is the orthocenter of OBC. So this is the complete information about orthocenter. In the next class we will talk about the in-center and the circumcenter.